today we'll be showing you how to paint the Hound of Wrath from the Warcry Bloodhunt set. This guide aims to show you how to get your miniatures slaughtering their opponents on the gaming table in no time at all. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about it. The series is linked in the description box below. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this, we've chosen to use grey sear. It's also a really good idea to make sure you've got a pot of grey sear to hand as well, just in case you need to tidy up any areas back to the undercoat before we apply a paint over them. The paints used are listed on screen now, but remember, these are just our suggestions. It's your hobby, so paint however you like. So the first thing we're going to do is apply Caraberg Crimson to the fleshy areas and the cloth. Now this is a very pigmented shade, so it does a great job of tinting the surface and shading the recesses at the same time. It behaves almost like a contrast paint. If you find it pooling too much in any of those recesses, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess paint. Over a light undercoat, like grey sear, which we've used here, shades can behave similarly to contrast paint. You might not often see shades used in this way, but it just goes to show how versatile the Citadel paint range is. So the next thing we're going to do is focus on the skin of the model. For this, we're going to be applying Cygore Brown. This is one of the larger sections on the model, and some of the areas are quite tricky to reach. So we're going to get this done early on in the guide, as it'll save us time tidying up later. When you're applying contrast paint, apply it heavily and neatly to the model. And as before with the shade, if there's any excess paint pooling too much anywhere, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. We're using a small base brush for this area, as it's large enough to be quick, and also small enough to help us be neat. We're using this particular colour to match the box art, but you can use whatever skin tone you'd like. Once the skin has dried, we're going to move on to the armour panels, and for these we'll be using Flesh Tearer's Red. Now before you apply this, you might just need to do a quick tidy up to those armour panels with some grey sear. This is just in case you've got any of that brown onto those grey areas, as the red is lighter and won't cover it. Applying this heavily to the armour panels will mean the paint naturally pulls away from the edges and creates the illusion of a highlight. When you're applying contrast paint, make sure that there's no water on your brush. This is because any water on your brush could dilute the paint and end up giving us an inconsistent finish on the model. Flesh Tearer's Red is a really nice deep red, which is great for Khorne armour. And the next thing we're going to do is apply Black Templar to the hair and wrappings. Apply this paint just like you've done with the other contrasts. So we want to be as neat as we can when we're applying this around areas like the red armour. However, we can relax a little bit when we're near the brown areas, as these colours will actually blend really nicely together. And with that done, we're now going to move on to the metallics. And we're going to start off by using Runelord Brass. This is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with a little bit of water just to get a smoother consistency. Then we want to build that up on the model in a couple of thin layers. Doing this just avoids any texture building up on the miniature and make sure we get that nice smooth finish. Now this might look a little bit bright, but don't worry, once we've applied a shade over it, it's going to look really nice and aged. And now we're going to move on to the silver areas. For these, we're going to use Lead Belcher. Apply this in just the same way you did with the Runelord Brass. Again, it might take a couple of coats. Once you've finished using metallic paints, it's always a good idea to change your paint water. Doing this will prevent any of those metallic flakes getting into your non-metallic paints and making them shiny. And once that stage is finished, that's all of our colours on the model, which just leaves us with a couple of final stages to finish off. And now we're going to use Agrax Earthshade on the metallic areas. This shade works really nicely over both the silver and the brass areas. It just helps to add a really nice grimy effect. Agrax Earthshade works really well over loads of different base coats, so it really is a staple paint for your collection. At this point, you might find it easier to switch back to that small base brush. This will just help us get the job done a little bit quicker. Applying a shade like this will mean it seeps into the recesses where two colours meet. This will help blend all of the colours together and create a unified finish across the miniature. Once that shade's dry, we can move on to the final stage of the process, and we're going to dry brush the black areas using Dawnstone. So for this, we're using a small dry brush, as this will help us be neat. We're also using the dry paint version of Dawnstone, as these paints are specifically formulated for dry brushing. However, if you don't have this at home, you could just use the layer paint version of it. When you're dry brushing, you want to remove as much of the paint off the brush as possible, so work it onto a paper towel in crisscross and circular motions. Once there's just a small amount of paint left on the brush, you can then take that onto the model. Dry brushing is done by moving the brush backwards and forwards and in circular motions across the raised detail of the miniature. Doing this creates a subtle highlight and we get this effect really quickly. Make sure the first pass you do over the miniature with this is quite subtle, and then if you want a brighter highlight, you can go in and do a second. Once you've finished and you're happy with the highlight, you can then take a clean brush and use this to just dust off the model. Dry brushing can leave small particles of dry paint on the model, and we don't want it to look dusty after all that hard work. There we are, your Hound of Wrath is finished and looking murderous. You can see that our model is based, and if you'd like to learn all about basing, you can check out our video on it. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Bye!